Hi everyone, my name is Adam Kocoloski with IBM Cloud, and I'm here to talk to you today about data lakes, what they are, how you use one, and the kind of things you ought to be thinking about as you set one up to power your applications and sort of create more intelligent experiences for your users. So data lakes exist because we're all, you know, awash with data, right? We've got systems of record, we've got systems of engagement, we've got streaming data, we've got batch data, internal, external data. And it's really a combination of these different kinds of data sources that leads us to get powerful insights about, you know, what our users are doing, about the way the world is working around us, and, you know, leads us to develop more intelligent applications. Data lakes start by collecting all those different types of data sources through a common ingestion framework. And that ingestion framework is something that typically wants to be able to support a diverse array of different types of data. And it wants to kind of standardize and centralize all that stuff into a common storage repository. That's not always required, but typically you don't want to be analyzing the source data directly. You want to be able to take a copy of it so that you've got the flexibility to do the kind of things you need to do with that data. And speaking of that, the data typically doesn't come in a form where you can use it right out of the box. There's a lot of, you know, data cleansing and data preparation that's required, right? There is oftentimes the ability to, or the requirement to create new features, something we call feature extraction. Combinations of different types of data that need to be pulled together in order to create the right sort of bits of information to analyze, right? And once you've sort of cleansed that data, prepped the data, modeled the right kind of features for your analysis, then you get to the fun part, which is actually going in and doing the machine learning model training, right? Doing your advanced analytics. And each of these steps is typically creating new derived data sources, you know, data sets that tie back to the original one. Right? And that relationship is a really important thing to capture, because let's say there was a problem with one of your data sources. You know, there was a correction that needed to be made. You need to understand how that flows through the entire pipeline of more refined data sets and models that you're producing so that you can go back and correct it. And that's where this governance stuff comes into play. This is something that's really, you know, infused at every step of the journey. It means collecting metadata, you know, data about your data, you know, the right kinds of information about the tables in your data sets and how they relate to one another. And it means being able to enforce policies so that as an organization, we use the data the way it's meant to be used, the way it's intended to be used, the way it's acceptable to be used to drive the business forward. So that's really something that can't be bolted on after the fact. It's something that has to be present throughout the entire life cycle. And if we stopped here, we haven't really changed anything, right? It's only by getting these insights that we're producing in this data lake back out into the real world that we're able to, you know, deliver on the business promise of these data lakes that we're all investing in. And that's where this app, you know, the apply step comes in. And this can take a few different forms, right? You might be, you know, building simply dashboards that are helping, you know, business executives make smarter decisions about where to take the business forward, about, you know, sort of new projects to invest in. Or you might be building smarter applications that are able to make, you know, intelligent recommendations to the users of those apps based on, you know, historical purchase data. And increasingly, we're also seeing a lot of process automation where, you know, an intelligent model can smooth over some typically manual business processes and create a more intelligent experience end-to-end based on, you know, this sort of rich data-driven understanding of the problem at hand. And, you know, really this whole process iterates back, right? Those more intelligent applications, they end up generating new data and the cycle continues. And so that, in a nutshell, at a very high level, is what a data lake does. Some of you may have heard us talk about the ladder to AI, the AI ladder. And when we talk about that, we talk about collecting data. We talk about organizing data. We talk about analyzing. And we talk about infusing. And really, those four steps on this ladder are things that you can see represented throughout this data lake environment. Right? Clearly over here, we're doing a lot of collection of these individual sources of data. This data preparation and feature extraction step in a governed fashion is absolutely what we mean by the organizing of data. ML model training is a key example of data analysis. And when we talk about infusing you know, the insights from the data lake into applications, that's really this last step here. And so there's very, very much a clear linkage between, you know, climbing this AI ladder and a data lake, you know, as a vehicle that can help you, you know, make that journey. If you enjoyed this content, please consider liking or subscribing. Thank you.